with Scott's armour, because I know he does believe that Mary Hunter, sorry. Sorry, it's very easy to get confused between the two, you know. Well, point being, of course, though, that Mary Hunter is some sort of S&P diehard, ousted from the recent council elections or local elections to a transgender of all individuals. But there's been the proverbial hot take from time to time from Mary Hunter. One of the latest ones being, of course, Neil Oliver, the long-haired dick, again another reference to Scott's armour, where he had somebody on GB News called Peter Sweden, who's allegedly a Holocaust denier, and Mary Hunter with her hot takes and musical, you know, said something to the tune of that. Anybody that's wondering why Neil Oliver has got a Holocaust denier on hasn't really been paying much attention to his trajectory as of late, insinuating, of course, that Neil Oliver is far right. This is the sort of cretin that we're dealing with here. However, this tweet that you can see here, here is the cost of Brexit and a vision of Scotland's future in the UK. You yes, yes. Are you yes, yes? Yes to what would be my question to you, Scooter? Look at this. South Side separatist. A separatist. Oh, is that so? I could really make mincemeat out of the argumentation pertaining to anybody that insinuates that they're a separatist, but I'll leave that for another day. Mary Hunter. My point of contention for this video is actually something, albeit it started off with a bit of a comical side to it. It's a pretty serious subject matter, in truth. For different reasons as to why Mary Hunter Scooter would imply it was the case. But it's a serious issue for all that. So obviously the tweet in question that Mary Hunter here is responding to is from Tom Gordon. Hollywood watchdog predicts falling population and low economic growth for 50 years. Okay? So I'm not going to spend too much time on the article per se, because I'll just go through the statistics somewhat after the fact. Hollywood watchdog predicts falling population and low economic growth for the next 50 years. Now, I'm not going to focus too much per se on the economic side of things for this video in particular. First and foremost, every single country across the Western Hemisphere is headed on the same trajectory, irrespective of what country that might very well be, because it's all part and parcel with the agenda that's on full display. You know, acceleration 101 for the good of sustainability. My point of contention for this video is the population aspect of things, and on top of that, it's a serious matter. In fact, it's a pressing matter in many respects, and I just find it abhorrent, in truth, that someone like that, just the S&P in general. I'm going to put forth a couple of clips in just a second for you to kind of get a bit of an understanding as to what the SNP solution has always been when it comes to the conversation pertaining to a decline in our population. They never ask as to why that's the case. They never asked, or they never suggest solutions that could be put into place to sort of rectify the issues. They don't even go along with the idea that these things could be put into effect, meaning, you know, the things at the aforementioned rectifications. They just go along with the concept that immigration is the sole solution to our problems, which in and of itself, by the way, in and of itself showcases one thing, and that is that you are effectively nothing short of, you know, expendable. And I've said this so many times before, the people of Scotland routine. What do you think that means? It means people living in Scotland. So the Scottish people all of a sudden have no label, no identity. So you know, are you yes yet? Yes to what? So our declining birth rates can be rectified by simply voting to leave the UK to rejoin the European Union, Mrs. Mary Hunter / Scooter, the side separatist. Nah.
It is one of our greatest strengths, but there's actually a less altruistic reason. We need to grow our population over the years to come because our natural demographics are not positive. So we need to attract people to come here so that we've got those to do the jobs and service the economy that we need. So that's
as a result of COVID and Brexit. The Scottish Government has been actively working to resolve these challenges over a matter of months, but we do need the help and the support of this Parliament and of the UK Government. And that's why I'm calling on the Parliament to support the Government's work to protect the provision of services and the delivery of goods through our supply chains, and calling on the UK Government to commit to establishing a joint task force on labour market shortages with the Scottish Government. We need action, we need engagement from the UK Government, we need a migration system that works for Scotland.
Secretary Angus Roberts.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. There's no quick fix for the challenges leading to depopulation, and we must work with regional, local and community partners to ensure that we collectively deliver a sustainable solution to the challenges facing our rural and island populations. Many of these challenges have been exacerbated by Brexit, the increased barriers to migration, which has helped offset an ageing population and keep services running, will leave a particularly damaging gap in our rural communities, and the Scottish Government continues to call upon the UK Government to make vital reforms to the immigration system to meet Scotland's needs.
Yesterday, Committee Universities Scotland said the priority must be to make our economy more competitive to attract people of working age from beyond our borders and encourage more Scots to spend their working lives here. So while we lack powers over immigration, we can still attract workers from elsewhere in the UK. So how will the Scottish Government address these demographic challenges?
Demographic challenges are facing all countries, but they're particularly acute in a Scottish context, and they have, you know, clearly a big impact on the future sustainability of our public finances. Now, there are short technical things we need to do, technical but very important things in terms of the spending review, the review of the fiscal framework, which will determine to some extent the flexibilities year on year that a Scottish Government has to manage some of this. But fundamentally, in longer term, it's about ensuring that we have a population that is fit for, you know, the modern economy that we're seeking to create. Now, we seek to encourage people to come here. We do that in a number of ways. We do that through the international marketing campaigns to encourage people here. We encourage students to come and study here and then try to encourage them to stay. We work with businesses to recruit internationally, and we will continue to do all of that happily for Scotland. I think we have an absolutely fantastic prospectus to put to people in terms of everything that we've got to offer, from the sectors that are at the cutting edge of the developments we're seeing globally right now, through to, you know, the beautiful environment that we have in Scotland for people to live in, the quality, you know, public services we have in Scotland. You know, we are deemed to have the best educated workforce in the whole of Europe, I think. So there's a lot to commend us, but I can't, in answering this question, put to one side the fact that we don't have control of immigration, which would always be a constraint, but less of a constraint if you had a sort of neutral immigration policy that wasn't working against your attempt to grow the population. We face an immigration policy that is in absolute conflict with what we're seeking to do in terms of the growth of our population.
You yes yet? So, as I said, there's a consistent theme, has been for some time, when it comes to the SNP's rhetoric. And it's not limited to the SNP, of course, nor is it limited to Scotland, for that matter. It seems to be the political consensus worldwide, especially in Western nations, anyway, that the answer to our declining demography is simply immigration. But as I said already, in going down that route, it effectively means, mathematically speaking, without being conspiratorial in any shape or form, if you continue to go down that trajectory and the trends that are already occurring continue to occur and get worse as time progresses, then the importation of people, if you have the ability to do so, alongside the already declining demography of the country, it will get to a point where not only will Scots, in this case, this context, end up being minority or in a minority status, but eventually they're just going to die out. Where is the concern from these people? Now, for a government who spend the vast majority of their time, whether it's talking about sustainability or well-being, they seem to be hell-bent on interfering with every aspect of your life because apparently they care about you so fucking much. But if that was the case and they cared about us as people that they can't even bring themselves to mention, by the way, that said, if they cared so much about us and they were that hell-bent and that determined to interfere into every facet of your life and into our societies at a local level and in a more nationalistic level or national level even, why are they not putting things into place to try and rectify the problems that we're seeing currently? They speak or they pretend that they're concerned about the demography of our country going forward, but yet they never, ever talk to, never mention, they don't even mention it. You know, it's one thing to act upon the policies that could be put into place to try and rectify the problem, but the fact of the matter is they won't even mention what could be done. They don't even go that far. No, instead it's immigration and solely immigration. You yes yet? Nah, I'm fucking not. It's a joke. So, so this is from, this was just the, this is from the NRS. This is what the article on National Records of Scotland, this is what this is about, obviously. The summarisation. Do I need to read this? I'll read a bit. Why not? I am pleased to once again provide some introductory comments to the Registrar's General Annual Review. Since 1855, Registrar Generals have delivered an annual report to Parliament and the public, or Scottish public, or the people of Scotland. Although these have evolved over time, they detail key information on birth, deaths and marriages. They provide invaluable statistics that help describe and provide further insights into how Scotland's population is changing, and some of the challenges facing modern Scotland. Right, but it's all this year, how our population is changing. Where's the concern? Where's the concern? Modern Scotland, aye. So anyway, I'm gonna skip past the economical side of things. I just want to speak about the population aspect for this video in particular. So, in fact, no, let me just put this into the video as well, actually. Deprivation. In 2021, we saw the second highest number of drug deaths ever recorded. What was the difference between the record high? If I remember correctly, it was about nine. Nine less people died, making it the second highest as opposed to being on par with the first or the record high. Drug misuse deaths, the rate for that was over 3.5 times higher than the UK's overall rate, and higher than the rates reported for any other EU country. Isn't that scandalous? I suppose that's the Tories' fault too. Are you yes yet? In 2021, people in the most deprived areas, depravity is quite a rife problem in our country, are you yes yet, were 15.3 times as likely to die from drug misuse as those in the least deprived areas. The ratio has increased over the past two decades. In the early 2000s, those in the most deprived areas were around 10 times as likely to have a drug misuse death as those in the least deprived areas. Alcohol-specific deaths also increased, by the way, but they were 5.6 times as likely to occur in the most deprived areas of Scotland compared to the least deprived. Over time, this ratio has generally decreased. Well, it still was one of the most record high. Well, it was one off, so don't hand me that. But has increased, well, there you go, aye. It's increased again in the last few years. That's probably due to lockdowns, etc., which the SNP were complicit in engaging in. So, are you a yes yet? No, I'm fucking not. Changes in the ratio are mostly driven by changes in death rates in the most deprived areas. This is because rates in the least deprived areas have remained stable over time. Here's the section that I just wanted to focus on, not to take anything away from suicidality or alcohol or drug-related deaths. I've spoken about this a few times on my channel before. Issues that are somewhat important to my heart, in truth. So I'm taking nothing away from it, but I just want to focus on population. If past trends continue, we project that by 2045, Scotland will have a smaller and older population. Growth from migration would no longer offset the growing gap between births and deaths. For the first time in a number of years, we project Scotland's population to fall in the next decade, starting from around 2029, with Scotland being the only UK country with a projected fall by 2045. Now, of course, in Scotland, for the last decade or so, all of our population growth, as it stands, has come from immigration. So much so that as each year has come and gone, our population has continued to reach record new highs. And that is despite the fact that, as I already read it earlier on, pertaining to 1855, when these records started, our birth rate has been plummeting to such a point that it is at the lowest on record, only slightly increasing, ever so slightly, may I add, as a caveat, last year, prior to Jibby Jabbies, by the way. So that's a problem in and of itself. Immigration is the only thing that's continued to bolster our population. But my point of contention is, will always be, and will never change, is the fact that there is nothing that has ever been put into place to try and rectify these issues. I'm not a medical worker, you know, I can't wave a magic wand and encourage people to procreate. But my point is, as I keep saying, there is nothing being done at all. Nothing. They don't even talk about it. Not a damn fucking thing. So it says that we also project that almost half of our 32 local authorities will decline in population over the next decade. And then it says that the population is also ageing. By 2045, we project that there will be fewer children, roughly the same number of people of working age, and more people of pensionable age. Esther Ruffside, statistician, head of population migration statistics. I'm pretty sure there's a wee bit underneath this as well. Population decline. The population is projected to peak in 2028 at 5,480,000. It is then projected to fall by 1.8% to 5.3 million by 2045. And three factors are causing population change in Scotland. Births. People are having fewer children. Okay? Why can the statisticians say it, but the government can't talk about it? What's been done to incentivise, encourage? Where's the discussions on this matter? They are non-existent. Non-existent. Just like references to us as a people. Non-existent. We're expendable, because the solutions that the SNP have got, as few and far between as they are, we'll just open the borders. Let's just import people. It's Brexit's fault. You know, if we had freedom of movement, you know, which is in and of itself a load of shite. Deaths. Over the long term, people are living longer, although these improvements have stalled and reversed in recent years. Well, I wonder what that was about, like. Migration. People moving to Scotland from the rest of the UK and outside the UK is projected to be to be in roughly equal numbers. And then they've got a wee bar graph here. Natural change in net immigration in Scotland with projections from 1956 to 2045. And yeah. let me see. Well, as if this is the solution to all of our problems. Oh no. Aging population. Population change. Let me see. We project that almost half of 32 of local authorities will decline in population over the next decade. Most of these authorities are in the west and southwest of Scotland. They tend to be local authorities with a higher percentage of more depravity or a higher percentage of rural areas. Their populations are generally projected to decline due to more deaths than births without enough immigration to compensate. See again. Why is this so open? Why do they say it so matter-of-factly? Immigration should be your plan Z. You should try everything within your power to try and stop the current trends, or at least pretend to, but they don't. So, you know, it's immigration, like. In contrast, most of the central belt and other urban areas are projected to grow in population, with most of the growth being likely to be from immigration. With people moving from other council areas, the rest of the UK, and of course, outside the UK, of course. And then it goes on to talk about projected population change, population decline, etc. And then it goes on about other shite. Marriage and civil partnership, fuck off. Anyway, to conclude, I just firmly believe that there needs to be, at the very bare minimum, a national conversation about what we do about our birth rates. And the silence from our government's deafening, in truth. It really is. Peace.